was coming in after the EC rejected charges by Mallikarjun Kharge, Congress president, over poll mismanagement and data mismanagement. Particularly, the Congress delegation is set to meet the ECI. They have in fact responded to the poll panel, saying that the EC has described, or the charges rejected by the EC does not have any legitimate issues, and thereby the Congress president Mallikarjun Kharge, the issues raised by him had in fact held political relevance. They have once again cast doubt over the Election Commission of India, raising questions over the delay, as they call, in sharing the poll data. My colleague Shereen is joining us, I believe. Shereen, if you can hear me, what is the next course of action? The Congress obviously is refusing to budge, and they are in fact in the process of meeting the ECI officials. So what happens now?
Well, the official time to meet the Election Commission was around 5 p.m. and not just the Congress party, but a delegation of the India Alliance is in fact going to meet the ECI today regarding how there is a delay in putting out the numbers for the voter turnout number for the third phase. Remember, for the first and the second phase, there was a delay of about 10 days delay in the first phase and 4-day delay in the second phase of voter turnout, which was in fact a bone of contention among the opposition parties. They had in fact attacked the Election Commission for the delay, saying that this is unprecedented in previous elections. In within 24 hours, the voter turnout had usually come out. And after which we have seen the Congress President Mallikarjun Kharge writing letter to the India Alliance leader, saying that there is some sort of discrepancy that is going on when it comes to the voter turnout in Election Commission, to which we have seen that the Election Commission has put out a strong word, in fact attacked Mallikarjun Kharge, saying that he has put out false narrative. It is in fact his opinion, an unbiased opinion, that he has in fact put out when it comes to Election Commission. And now we are seeing senior leaders like Jairam Ramesh, P. Chidambaram, all coming in attacking the Election Commission for using such strong words against Mallikarjun Kharge, saying that the criticism against Election Commission is something that should be accepted by them. But they are in fact in attacking the opposition party for questioning the delay in the voter turnout.
But Shereen, tell me also, it'll help us understand, as far as the Election Commission is concerned, what was it in their reply? How have they justified the allegations levelled by the INDIA Alliance, which has said that not only there has been a delay in publishing data of the voter turnout, but also they've hinted at conspiracy, pretty big charge levelled by the INDIA side, and clearly they are not budging. What was the EC's response to that?
Well, they have in fact said that as far as the first phase and second phase is concerned, in the letter they have attached the voter turnout, also saying that when it comes to each of the constituency numbers, they have already been put by the evening of each of the phases. And when it comes to the first phase, second phase, third phase, in all these three phases, they have approximately put out the voter turnout. Now, they have to get numbers from each of the returning officers, and by the time it reaches, it becomes a bit difficult to put the numbers on time. So by putting a narrative that there is some sort of a discrepancy that is going on, the Election Commission has put out a strong word against Mallikarjun Kharge, saying that this is nothing but a fear-mongering that is done by a president of a party. Also says that he is in fact indulging in an attempt to deliberately create confusion, and also attacking the free and fair conduct of the election that is conducted for many years by the Election Commission. So very strong words against Congress President Mallikarjun Kharge that is coming in from the Election Commission, and clearly this has not gone down well with the Congress party, and that is why we are seeing senior leaders like Jairam Ramesh and P. Chidambaram actually asking Election Commission that what sort of words are they actually using against Mallikarjun Kharge, because a little criticism is not being accepted by the Election Commission at this point, is what the charge that is coming in from the Congress party.
All right, Shereen, we'll leave it at that. Do track the updates for us. Meanwhile, here back in Guntur, on the other side, we've got an exclusive campaign trail with Nara Lokesh. A lot is riding on him. Stay tuned.